Underneath the Salton Sea's toxic lake bed is an estimated 18 million metric tons of lithium suspended in hot geothermal brine. That's enough to power more than 375 million EV batteries. California's largest lake has the world's biggest concentration of lithium in geothermal brine, which could make the U.S. self-sufficient in the mineral. It's a revival for the area, which was a thriving vacation spot until the 1960s.
The miracle sea in the desert, the Salton Sea.
But today, the shrinking lake is an environmental disaster, leaving behind toxic dust in the surrounding desert community. Still,
the Salton Sea region presents a once-in-a-generation opportunity.
But seizing that opportunity isn't easy. Getting to all that lithium requires new tech, like this, to stand up against the corrosive conditions. At stake is hundreds of billions of dollars worth of lithium and thousands of white-collar jobs. Here's how companies are racing to develop new ways to extract lithium from this toxic lake, and whether that will provide a lifeline or be a threat to the surrounding Imperial Valley.
This resource is really high up there in terms of both sustainability and scalability as well.
David Deke leads strategy and development at Energy Source Minerals, one of three companies competing to extract lithium at the Salton Sea. Inside this nondescript shipping container is the pilot version of the tech that could give this area new life. Part of what makes the Salton Sea unique is its huge reserve of geothermal brine, a mix of superheated salty water rich in minerals. That geothermal brine has been mined for green energy since the 1980s. But companies are now eyeing something even more valuable than steam power, lithium. Energy Source is developing a less resource-intensive way to extract it from the brine. Right now, most of the world's lithium is extracted from Australia's open-pit mines or South America's evaporation ponds. Both processes are water-intensive and can create a lot of contamination and waste. The new method is called direct lithium extraction, or DLE, and it adds just a few steps to the geothermal energy generation already happening at the Salton Sea. Once that geothermal energy is pulled out, the brine is deposited back into the reservoir.
But what we're working on is a process for which we intercept that return process where we will then extract lithium and turn that into product.
Lithium extraction begins here, where brine is passed to this machine, full of plastic tubes and columns, carrying what's called an adsorbent.
This is our secret sauce. The way it works is that it's a very high surface area material. Think of it as sort of like a sponge that's selectively absorbing lithium and nothing else.
In those same columns, the company strips the lithium out of the adsorbent with water.
We are comfortably extracting over 90% of the lithium that comes out.
That's double what can be extracted from brine using more traditional methods like evaporation ponds. The final product is this clear solution, purified lithium chloride.
We can further process this into a solid product that we can package and send out to battery makers and EV producers.
The company plans to start building the commercial facility in 2024, with commercial lithium production beginning in 2027. Once it's built, Energy Source expects to process 20,000 metric tons of lithium every year, enough for 500,000 EV batteries alone. Ford has already signed on to buy some of that supply. While Energy Source is gearing up to go commercial, there's competition on its heels. Berkshire Hathaway Energy currently operates 10 of the 11 geothermal plants around the Salton Sea.
They own most of the resource and they will dominate eventually the production of lithium down here.
Meanwhile, a third player, Controlled Thermal Resources, is working to catch up. Unlike the other two companies, CTR doesn't currently own or operate a geothermal plant. But in January, it began construction on the first phase of its lithium facilities, which will produce 25,000 tons of lithium product every year. That's more than four times the amount the U.S. currently produces. All this interest has turned the area into
what we refer to as the Saudi Arabia of lithium.
Right now, the U.S. makes less than 1% of the world's total lithium supply, most of which is mined in Nevada. The Salton Sea's reserves could transform domestic production. They are estimated to contain enough lithium to ultimately produce nearly half of current global output.
It is used in everything from electric vehicle batteries to battery storage to cell phones. And so the opportunity to potentially recover lithium in such a high volume is of particular interest.
It's taken years to get to this point, and it will still be years before any lithium production begins at a commercial scale.
This type of brine that comes from this region, it is highly mineralized. Many elements of the periodic table you will find in this brine, and it's very hot, which means that it can be quite a corrosive brine. A lot of this tubing and processing is done with plastics or with special non-corrosive metals.
The drying Salton Sea itself makes extraction even more difficult.
10 years ago, the water was up to the edge of the volcano, and it's now receded off into the distance.
Since 1999, the Salton Sea has shrunk by more than 30%. The receding shorelines, fueled by drought, have decimated the region's ecosystems and exposed more than 30,000 acres of toxic lake bed.
The current sea, which formed in the early 1900s, has been maintained largely due to agricultural runoff. But associated with that runoff are pesticides and fertilizer components.
It's this material that gets airborne and generates dust that creates asthma problems in children and the elderly.
That toxic dust is laced with bacteria, heavy metals, and carcinogens like DDT, threatening the community and growing workforce that a multi-billion dollar lithium industry would bring to the region.
In order for the lithium economy to be successful down here, they need to have a healthy workforce. You don't want to bring in a workforce that's going to have chronic asthma all the time.
Some Imperial Valley residents are concerned lithium extraction could worsen the region's environmental issues. Right now, it's unclear how operations could affect health problems. That's why some community leaders, like Luis Olmedo, say the lithium industry should spearhead efforts to tackle the toxic dust. Olmedo is the executive director of Comité Cívico del Valle, a nonprofit that advocates for environmental justice.
We're predominantly communities of color, farm-working communities, low-income communities. Part of our role is to make sure that there are fair and equitable negotiations.
Imperial County has the highest unemployment rate in California, and nearly a quarter of children live in poverty. But jobs in the lithium industry promise a new way of making ends meet. Imperial County estimates the industry could bring as many as 81,000 jobs to the region. While the lithium industry could bring an economic boost, water use remains a concern in a region that receives just 3 inches of rainfall each year.
The main use of water in the Imperial Valley is for agriculture. If we want to have a successful lithium industry here, we've got to make sure some of that water gets used for lithium processing.
In January, Comité Cívico del Valle filed a notice of intent to sue the county after it approved the plans for Controlled Thermal Resources' new lithium facilities. Overuse of Colorado River water and industry pollution were two of the key complaints. In a statement, the county said that since the beginning of Lithium Valley, it has worked to guarantee that residents and communities directly benefit from the economic and environmental advancements these developments herald. As momentum for lithium extraction builds, community leaders want to see written agreements from companies on their community commitments.
We want them to be able to do business here, but everyone in this community that is doing business here needs to do their own investments and making sure they mitigate their pollution.
In a step towards ensuring the community benefits, Governor Gavin Newsom signed legislation allowing Imperial County to tax every metric ton of lithium produced. The majority of the revenue is slated for Salton Sea restoration and community benefit projects. Amid the promises of a lithium gold rush, the future of the dwindling Salton Sea remains less certain. While there are plans in place to tackle some of the region's toxic dust, they aren't a long-term fix.
We have the greatest economic opportunity in our history to be able to turn up enough supply of lithium for this entire country and the world. But we can only accomplish success if we have mitigation, if we have community benefits.